To the Adrift. Let me just hop on here. I'm checking to make sure that all our connections and things are still functioning. Cake, Mavarinthia says. Hello, Mavarinthia. I'm sorry if my chat responses are a little slow. We are running chat on my telephone tonight. But yes, welcome. We're going to play No Man's Sky tonight, and I'm going to switch to chat-only mode once I've verified that everything starts properly. I'm very excited about this. Who knows, the chat might be faster. It might be. It might be. Hopefully we're not gonna intrude on my frames too much, because this game is very hungry for RAM, is what I have discovered in my brief tinkering with it in the 2 hours, I guess, since I've downloaded it. I have not played any yet. I've just sort of opened it up and run it and tried to get OBS to capture it properly. So, do let me know if the volume needs adjusting or anything of that sort. We're going to bump up the volume on the computer on the on OBS, so the mix just a tiny bit. And now that that's settled, we will begin. I think I can minimize OBS and begin No Man's Sky. 2 seconds. Okay, all right, just had to make sure my controller was plugged in. Here we go, we're starting No Man's Sky. Alright. I'm so excited for this game. You have no idea. Alright, now that I've confirmed that it is running on my machine, I will go switch to chat-only mode if I can. There must be a way to do it. Apologies if you're in chat and I'm just kind of missing your stuff. Twitch mobile is a little odd. Online. Chat. That's the tab I want. Okay. So that's functioning. And I've got my controller, so it says initialize. Alright. This is brand new virgin territory here. I guess I press the X button instead of the A button. Oh, I hold it down!
Commencing assistance suit initialization.
Okay.
Life support systems activated.
Oh my gosh. Oh my gosh. It does sound like GLaDOS. So I am not controlling this at the moment. It's just looking around as I'm waking up here. It's feeling very cinematic.
Scanner damaged. Repair required.
Repair required. Okay, cool. I don't have control yet. We are just getting a glance around at our surroundings. We have a jetpack? Oh my god. Oh my god, we have a jetpack.
Multi-tool and mining laser attachment. Operational.
Sweet. Okay. So that's my multi-tool. We are kind of chugging in terms of frame rate.
User initialization sequence.
But that's okay, because my laptop is not really designed for gaming. Planet Awakes Kantals, Euclid Galaxy. I discovered this on 2016, August 12th at 2108. Okay, and there's a little robot. Hello, robot? If unredeemed items, to claim them, please use the options menu. That's great. You know what? We're just gonna look around at first. Okay, so I'm probably gonna have to adjust the quality settings a little bit. Let's see what we've got here. Okay, online service. Okay, and it does list me as The Adrift, which is great. I was worried it was gonna use my Steam username, not my Steam screen name, which is something that I picked out in high school, and I feel like, oh man. But, oh, no, I don't want. Oh god. Okay, this is weird. I used my mouse by accident, but now I'm using the back. Moving very slowly. Scanner critically damaged. Carbon. Need 25 to repair. Okay, I can jump. I am irradiated, apparently. Okay. How do I run? Oh, nope, that's not what I want. Okay. Can I... Controls. Reset everything to default. Alright, so... Move forward. It's on my gamepad. Swim up is A. Swim down is left bumper. Melee is right bumper. Interact is X. Activate torch is up thingy. Okay. I am feeling really weird about this cursor being here. This seems very odd. Alright, so sprint is hold down R. Really? Hold down R3? I wonder if I can... Why are they both R3? Oh dear. Okay, well, it looks like it looks like everything else is the spaceship's controls are going to be basically Starbox controls, which is good. I wonder if I can keep my screen from locking. Hold on my chat, because it's kicking me out. Settings. We're just going to temporarily disable the screen sleeping thing display. Sleep after 30 minutes is what we're going to say. Hopefully it didn't kick me out of... Okay, so now I can keep you guys up. All right. So, anyway, we're gonna try the default controls for a while. Okay, so that's sprint. It is not very fast, I must say. Okay, well, options. I think this game is just running really slowly, so options, normal, sure, redeem bonus content, because I pre-ordered this, so I guess I get a different spaceship? Okay. Yes. Oh, that's why it's got the little zippity-doo. Compare? I do not understand this. Okay, it looks like they've got the same things. Kerite sheet. I have old ship and new ship inventories. Yeah, I don't know what this is doing, so I think I'm probably just gonna leave the ship alone? I hope it lets me still get it later. Okay, I've got someone messaging me telling me that the new ship apparently makes things harder. I don't know anything, so I'm just gonna wait. What does that do to me? I'm sorry for just messing around with the menu here, folks. We're still just okay, cool. So I still have the option to do that later. So I will do that at a later date when I feel like I'm there. Alright, so we are in full screen, my primary monitor, VSync is on. Put field of view, flight field of view, max frame rate. Why is it still like so chuggy? If I turn VSync off, is that gonna... Alright, we're gonna keep things as they are for now, and because I don't know if that's gonna screw with the stream. Wow. There's so much stuff! harder. That sounds awesome. Let's do that. Let's hold on. I wanna figure out what the heck is going on first. All right, so I've traveled 67 units, which I guess is meters. Any more here? Okay. So one thing I am going to do for the controls is I'm going to change scan from L3 to R3. And same with I'm gonna change sprint to L3. And scan to R3. I think that's okay. All right. So, melee is right bumper. That feels weird, but I guess it makes sense if left bumper is trigger, or if right trigger is fire weapons. I'm still kind of. I'm not going to be using my weapons a lot. I don't think. Mouse look. Or move look. Yes, this is. Let's make this more sensitive. Let's try 70 instead of 50. Current. No data. Previous. No data. I don't understand what that means, but. Aliasing. Alright. So we'll hit back. Okay. I'm still moving really slowly. I'm not quite sure what is up with that, but Rasamama S36. I like that name. I like that name. Saying the tutorial skips tutorial. Yeah, I want all the tutorials. Oh, okay. I'm in my ship. Launch thruster critically damaged. Vital launch and landing gear system. User is advised that plutonium is required to recharge the thruster. Launch procedures require sufficient fuel levels before activation. So we need to get more kerite sheets to activate our to fix the engine. Yeah, I don't want to break any tutorial, so we're gonna hold off on getting the new ship. I think I like that better for the role playing too. Like, we'll get our new ship when we're in a position to get new ships. Oh, hello. There's a little guy flying nearby. Alright. So what happens if we try to hold the right trigger? Now we can't. Okay. So we need to get more kerite sheets. What happens? Move one. Move and stack. Okay, alright, so I need to grab more. Items. Oh, I have an experiment available. What does that do? Maybe my exosuit is what's keeping me from moving. secret sheet sphere on the bunny planet? No, no, this is a terrible idea. No carrots and spaceships. It's bad. Carrots and spaceships don't mix, okay? We've established this with Tenshi Muyo. Okay, so Exos suit here. Jetpack, life support. Okay. Hold A to take off. I've got lots of energy. Stamina. My stamina is zip. Okay. All right. I like how we are really just thrown into this. Can I get out, please? There we go. All right. So okay, now I've got a save game. All right. So this is like this is a little bit like what's it? The Canadian wilderness game. I'm gonna forget the name, and we'll come back. Longest, Long Dark, where you save when you get into your spaceship or when you rest or something like that. Okay, so interact with debris. Atlas Pass V1. What the heck is an Atlas Pass? Cargo. Oh, I've got an isotope. Okay, so there's our plutonium. So we can put that in our spaceship, which is absolutely fine to be holding in our pocket. We're just tickling the dragon's tail here. No worries. I got a Gra-gra. Oh, I can put stuff in my starship anytime. That's awesome. Like a free course at starship at Atlas. I don't get the reference. I'm sorry. Damaged machinery. Let's interact. Oh, I got a new technology. That's awesome. So I can find stuff and reverse engineer it so that I can make it. Oh, we're gonna have a good time. Ah, it's like they made this game for me. Okay. Let us go to our inventory. That's not how I get to my inventory. Nope. Oh wait, is that British live action game? I saw someone playing that. That was really cool looking. Actually, I think I put it on my wish list after I watched that. Okay, it's the back button on the controller is my inventory. We will figure this out. All right, so in my exosuit inventory, I've got a Gra-Gra. What is this? Gas inhaled by Vikine warriors to temporarily increase lung capacity and allow high-quality battle screams. Outlawed by very many peace agreements throughout the galaxy, many of which are now broken. So we found drugs. That's what this is. We got alien space drugs. Performance-enhancing materials. Yeah, I thought we watched Super Joe play. I remember watching it with you. I forgot that its name was Contradictions, so I was like, what is this? But yeah, it's stuck in my head as the full motion video game. It was pretty cool. Sounds legit. Yeah, space drugs. I'm just headcanoning that the Viking are the Jem'Hadar. We found their supply of Ketracel White. Okay. Plutonium. I need 250 of that. Let's transfer that.
Radiation protection falling.
Why is my radiation protection falling? Why is it? Oh no. Okay. We're gonna hang on to that. Is that charge?
Technology recharge.
Okay. Got it. Got it. Okay, so I have to. I click on the thing and click on the other thing to charge the thing. Very articulate. But I'm figuring it out. Okay. The first bit of this stream is probably going to be pretty boring with me just kind of playing like, what's this? What's this? How do I do this? Debris. Distress beacon. Do I want to activate a distress beacon? I see a lot of fighter jets flying around. Just press X to not die too. Yeah, I saw that one. We watched a bit of that one, I think, too, maybe? I've seen it. I think I saw it with you. I could be wrong. My memory of it is very vague. Uh-oh. Reality seems to fold in on itself. One moment, I can see debris. In another, a vast red orb, almost too large and bright to behold. It knows me, inside and out, more than I ever could myself. Could this be the face of creation itself, or, in my hazy, freshly awakened state, am I being manipulated? A name burns itself into my mind. Atlas. And a request, made without words, that I should follow the path this being, this Atlas, has set for me. And I have. We have a choice. We can accept the Atlas's guidance, or we can spurn direction and explore freely. I mean, is this like if I spurn direction, does that just mean I am giving up the tutorial? Or gotta mull this over here. Also, I like how the menu kinda swivels. Arcade Royal says join the religion. I mean, what harm could it possibly do? It's just a big red ball that probably lives in the black hole at the center of our galaxy. I think I'm probably being manipulated, but we'll accept guidance for now. The Alice acknowledges my allegiance, and I feel certain it will manifest itself again soon. Oh, good! Oh, good! Good for you! All right. The spice must flow, says Arcade Royale. I realize this is going to be very strange because I'm interacting with people who aren't appearing on screen in the VOD, but I also didn't want the chat to like intrude on the UI too much. So terribly sorry, YouTube viewers in the future. What is this under here? Can I? Okay, my visor. We need to get the scan visor. Oh, no, I don't. Oh, God! No, I don't want to shoot things. How do I put the gun away? How do I... I don't want... Oh my god. Oh, that was a mistake. That was a mistake. Yeah, the sirens are coming from the game. They are not coming from my ambient area here. Item. Nope. Don't want to do the rocket pack again. I turned it off. Okay. Cargo drop. Oxide. I got a shielding shard. Which noise? The siren noise? Yeah, it's not great. I want to get away from it as soon as possible. We're gonna try to. All right. Okay, I'm gonna charge my energy with the shielding shard because I just got that.
Technology recharge.
And hopefully that will help my health. Get back to normal? Maybe? It helped a little bit. I'm slowly healing. I'm guessing the Atlas Pass is the in-game... There's probably a bit of a free to... There's probably a bit of a microtransaction thing smooched into this, which is a little disappointing, but that's what that seems to be. Iron destroy. How do I destroy it? Can I punch it? I can punch it. The fallen crunchy squishy noise. You mean my organs? Grimau. those were my bones. I did not like that sound either. Okay, I got, man, that you have unredeemed items thing is really kind of miffing me. Alright, what can I use iron for? Zinc, titanium, or shielding charge. Isotope elements. I'm liking that the stuff is. All right, so I'm in my starship here. Got the plutonium in here, which needs to go. Okay. Right. I need to gather heridium for the pulse engine. I've got a photon cannon. Okay. What happens if I... Oh gosh. This layout probably means something. This means something. Hey, listen! Don't give Navi a hard time. Navi, she's just trying to get Link to do what he needs to do, and he's very stubborn. Let's see. Yeah, it's just constantly pestering me. I wish there was a way to turn that off, but I'm also like not gonna redeem it yet because I don't wanna. This layout here probably means something, like where I'm putting items, presumably? Like where I install them? I bet it's probably some kind of... Maybe I'm overthinking it. Who knows? It's a mystery! Alright. What happens if I repair? I cannot repair it yet because I do not have the appropriate thing. You cannot get ye flask. Okay. So I've looted all this stuff. These things are just flying in circles, and I'm a little concerned. I'm not gonna lie. I'm a little worried. So naturally, I'm going straight towards it. Ooh, crystals! Plutonium! Aw, yes. Let's use our fancy space gun. Pachoo! I got lots of plutonium. This is fine. This is fine. Oh, sorry, Maverinthia. I have links turned off in the chat. I keep forgetting to turn them back on. You can probably, put it in without the... Oh, hello. Hi. Who are you? Should I be worried? I'm not doing anything, officer. Just picking up some rocks. Multi-pass. Lilu Dallas multipass. Okay. Alright, I seem to have... Whew. Alright. So. We learned a thing. We learned that, if we break too many rocks, the local authorities become interested in us. And I do not want that. Should probably go to a different area. Yeah, I'm thinking, since I seem to have annoyed the robot cops, I need to get some more iron. Okay, so Navi is actually helping us now. That's good. Alright. Let's transfer... Oh, right. I can do this from my menu without actually having to, do the thing. Okay, first of all, we're gonna use... Aha! I'm getting the hang of this. Alright. We're gonna transfer the rest of this plutonium into our ship. Okay, what technology can I... Ooh! Okay, this is why we can't run. We don't have the run module installed. So this is Metroid, except we're building our power-ups. Got it. I'm down. I'm very down. Okay, well, there's nothing else for us here, and the cops are still being very, nosy. So, let us sprint. The equivalent of bee hopping is just hovering with our jetpack. Ooh. Okay, I can get iron from this plant. Or thamium. Thundermanium. Thundercats, ho! apologies if that's very loud. Do let me know how the volume balance is. I can turn the game down and or other such. Actually, all right. Nope. I'm not doing nothing, sirs. And or persons. Gender neutral, honorific, appropriate for robots. Arcade Rail says it's good. What's good? Oh. I hear robot cops. Let's get out of here. Cheese it! It's the cops! The audio. Oh, okay, cool. Good. Also, the cops make the most annoying sound. I am not a fan. Alright. So, I seem to not draw their attention if I just punch rocks. Oh, hello. Little creatures! It's Lying Cat! That's a Saga reference, which is a comic book written by one of the people involved with Lost and drawn by a very good artist whose name escapes me. But there's a guy in it. He's a bounty hunter. He's not one of the main characters, but he's got a cat that looks like a Sphinx cat and is huge and is green, and it only makes the sound lying when people are lying. So people will be talking in the dialogue and Lying Cat will just interrupt with lying. It's great. Anyway, check out Saga. I need to read more than just the first trade. Can I scan you? Look at you? I cannot get ye flask. Come back! I want to name the kitty! No! Okay, I can't name the kitty yet, so repairing our visor is top priority. Top priority. Top men. Alright. Multi-tool. We need more iron. Ooh, I've got iron. I need to get more of it.
Radiation protection falling.
Okay. Alright, so let's shoot some rocks. Got some iron. Oop. What was that? There are wolf noises. Oop. Gun is overheating. It's not good. Come back for a death machine. Yeah. Is really, I love cats. They're little, beautiful little murder machines. He's written way more comics. Lost is sort of a random part of his resume. Okay, that's really cool. I was not aware. I haven't watched Lost, which hopefully we'll be correcting soon, but, I really... Okay, I've got enough to repair the scanner. But I really enjoy Saga, so if the writing is similar, I'm definitely into that. Okay. So, can I go to the multi-tool and repair...
Yes!
we have the scan visor. Okay, now we're off to the races, because I am in this game to name all the to find all the things. I mean, not all the things, that's impossible, but... Scanner critically damaged. What? I just repaired the scanner! I just repaired the... No, I missed something. Hold left trigger to operate, then press LT to zoom. Okay. I got a thing! I named the cat! Wrong scan. Yeah, I think what it was is that you have to push... You have to open the scanner... And then... run the scanner. Only works on a handful of episodes of Stonehouse, and it will be... I'm still interested in seeing it. I was just fumbling to say that I quite enjoy... his writing in Saga, and will probably enjoy the episodes that he worked on as well. And the series as a whole. Alright, let's get some more. Is it me, or do we hear sheep somewhere? I definitely heard a freaking sheep. Alright. Let's get some more rocks. Okay, so using my mining beam is... is very slowly draining my battery as well, which makes sense. Oh, here comes the cops. Run! Okay, it's just looking right now. I don't think it figured out that it's me. The robot cops on this planet are going to be trying to solve the case of the mysterious Iron Puncher for quite some time. We should go to a different area. Let's try to do that. It worked on Catch 22, which is a good one. Oh, is that an episode of Lost? It's the Popo! Cheese it! Okay. Alright, so we've got iron. I can... No. How do I... That's not what I want to do. Can I... Oh, I did. I pressed the wrong button. Aha! Alright. Okay. So we can build... We can build it! We have the technology. We can rebuild him. Let us transfer that to my... No, I said transfer that to my spaceship. Boink! Alright, so now we have two. I have about 100 more, so I think I should be able to craft more? What is this? Bypass chip. Oh, cool! That's how I get into the Atlas Pass things, I bet. I betcha. Alright. Over here, we will craft another Kerite sheet. Gentlemen, we can rebuild him. We have the technology. Alright, I just need a tiny bit more. Alright, can we stack these? Yes, we can. No? Okay. Alright. We need to get a little bit more iron. Which hopefully we can snag by punching something. Let's look around for the popo. Can I scan the popo when they come to look at me? Probably. It's only fair. You have the right to take pictures of the police. Okay, that is definitely a whale sound. We're gonna find the space whale. Alright, now we should be able to, repair.
Radiation protection falling.
Yes, GLaDOS, I'm aware. I am aware. I need radiation protection. I did not mean to transfer all of my iron here. Oh well. Right, this is how we do that. We're getting there. Okay, now. Now we repair that. Fantastic. Now we need plutonium. We have thorium. Which will charge our. What else can we make? Can we make anything else? What do we need to make this warp cell? Oh, okay, we need 26... No, we have 26, we need 100 of the thorium. One antimatter. Oh boy! Electron vapor. Alright. Let us... Zinc, titanium, or shielding shard. How do we get a shielding shard? I do not know. Let's see if we can find something. Oh, I heard something. Small creature. Oh! No! No, I did not mean to shoot you! No, 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 no! Come back! Come back! Where'd you go? No! Tiny creature! Yes! Today's gender is orthogonal. Okay. See if I can make it back to my spaceship. Oh no! Thing closed. Cheese flavored popos. Okay. Yes, my life support systems are not doing so hot. We're gonna get back to the spaceship. Oh no! Does that charge my... Thorium 9 is required to charge the pulse engine. Alright, that's the stuff we were getting from the little mushroom plants. Okay. Can I? All right. My hazard protection shield is charged. My life support needs charging. We'll go ahead and charge that with some plutonium.
Technology recharge.
There we go. We did a thing. Got 25 more carbon to repair. Is it a spaceship thing? Is it the spaceship scanner that I'm repairing? No. I repaired the scanner. Oh, I see. There's two different. Aha! So the scanner makes a map, and the analysis visor makes the. Gotcha. Cool. All right. Out of our spaceship. Back into the fray. I betcha. Yeah, I've got an Atlas pad. I've got a. Hey, what's it? What does it do? Can I use it? No. Go back. How do I? How do I use it? I wish to subscribe to your newsletter. Oh well. Okay, so this barrel is just locked. So let's go away from the spaceships. We already got the plutoniums or the thomium things from that. We don't really need more iron at this point. What we need. Aha. What we need is carbon to repair our scanner. Come on. Punch the flower. Okay. That is a surprisingly hardy flower. I would just like to iterate that that flower can take a beating. Bam. I've been working on the railroad all the livelong day. I've been working on the railroad. Okay, cool. We got more carbon. Ooh. We can get aluminum too. Aluminium. Press back and then hold to repair. Zoop.
Technology prepared.
Excellent. Planetary exploration device that locates and highlights nearby points of interest. Plugs directly into brain, or, if user is of Korvax origin, connects to neural network cortex. Sweet. I wonder what a cortex is. Let's charge this with a. Ooh! Carbon is an isotope. Interesting.
Technology recharge.
Hopefully I didn't just waste all my plutonium. I just used all my plutonium. Good job. Go us. Go us. Let's see. Probably a space jellyfish. Resource deposit detected. That's good. I like those. Okay, so we've got more plutonium in the spaceship. Alright. That's good to know. Launch thruster requires plutonium. Pulse engine still needs to be repaired. Okay. Alright. Let's attempt to repair the thingy. First, though, we're gonna... Hello? Oh.
Radiation protection falling.
Let's get some aluminium. See what it does for us. Alright. Every time I use my mining laser, it goes down a percent. Good to know. Alright. Can I do anything with my fancy pantsy new aluminium? Technology requires iron and carbon. Oh, we can build that next. What other stuff have we got that we can do? Nothing. Nada. Niet. What if we want to craft a thing? Kerite sheet is just iron. Suspension fluid. Captured cloud of ion is electrons, fundamental component of many technologies and often used in the creation of antimatter. That seems important. Platinum and iron for that thingy, which we won't get soon. Domium and antimatter is the warp cell. Okay, alright, so we're not quite to the point of crafting a warp cell yet, but hey, we made it to dawn. It's so pretty here. Too bad the air is like radioactive and killing us slowly. More critters! Hi, critters! Who are you? Ooh, Ubleni Rursark. Age young, gender indeterminate. Temperament skittish. Is that the same? That's the same as that creature. It's a grazing creature. Iron oxide. Zoom. Oops. Okay, I get it. If we overheat our laser, it takes off more than one percentage point when it goes down. So we've got to be careful. It's just a tiny little bit of lag on the release. You got to be a little bit careful. Okay. Okay, so I think these guys are making the whale noises, which is pretty rad. Just going to check something here. Okay, I do have my headphones on the correct way. It just seemed like the noises were coming from the opposite direction of where they're meant to be. Ooh! I see what looks like a downed rocket over here. We're gonna take a look. Yes, thank you, computer. Alright, our our what's-it is using our battery, I think. Ooh, pretty leaves. Oh my gosh. You guys have no idea how long I've been waiting for a game where the point is go to space, wander around, see pretty things. It is looking pretty good, I must say. I'm enjoying this quite a lot. I lost track of the little thingy I was trying to get a look at. Oh. Music's pretty nice, when it does its little melody things. Alright, can I sprint now, please? Not very well. I wonder if the gravity here is high. That is a possibility. So this thing I thought was a spaceship is a tree? Is it a thing I can look at? No. Alright. Ooh, are you new critters? You are new critters! Hi, critters! Oh, it's a baby! How cute! So I don't actually know yet what the credits do for us, but I presume that is currency for doing things, which is great. I'm really digging that you can get credits by just like exploring and doing stuff. That's one of the things that I enjoy about there's an MMO called DC Universe Online, which I and Grimmel have been playing, and that game like rewards you for just kind of wandering around and finding stuff and looking at things, which is really cool. And I'm getting kind of the same sort of vibe from this, where it's like the reward schema is, hey, go look at the pretties, and you'll get stuff for it as well. I don't really need stuff to have a desire to go and look at the pretties, but it's nice that you get stuff for doing something I would already like to do. Can I scan these? No, only creatures. I'm only interested in animal Pokemon. So we're about a minute away from the this resource deposit that it's telling us to go and get. That is a pretty little plant. Okay, we're gonna need to use some plutonium here, I think. Let's transfer.
Radiation protection falling.
We don't need to transfer it, actually. We can just charge this.
Life support power low.
Okay, my life support is low. Which life support? Oh, hello? Can I scan you back? I don't like that it has guns. I'm not a fan of this drone having little guns on it. Where did I? Oh shoot! I headed down the hill in the wrong direction. Okay, my radiation suit is what needs charging, and I don't have the stuff to charge it. So I think we might get killed by radiation poisoning. Just a sneaking suspicion. Oh my gosh. It's so pretty. Alright. Looks a little bit like a Yes cover. Okay, cool. There's more animals to discover on this planet. That seems to be a flying thing. Or maybe that's me dying. I think that might be me dying. Okay. Right, well, I guess, I can't... Oh, no. Oh, no. Okay, well... I don't have any zinc. Shoot. Our hazard suit is gonna die any moment now. That's cool. Alright, let's try and get over here. Yes, hello police. There. Oh, it's this thing. Okay. So this is the thing that we need to fix our spaceship. Cool. Good to know. Let's get it. Dear. Alright, our Geiger counter is now going crazy. Yep, I'm aware. Whew. Alright. Well, we're getting a little taste of the Chernobyl spa treatment. God, it's gonna make us tear down this entire rock, isn't it? I bet it is. That's what it's looking like. Come on. Yep. Yep. So, I actually don't know yet if, yep. Okay, so I am being hurt. My health is ebbing very slightly. Come on. Birds! Sorry. I like the birds. I want... Give birds? Birds? I need to get higher. Whoa. Everything went very cyberpunk all of a sudden. Uh cool. I think. Alright, I wonder if I can get... Oh, I see! Okay. Can I go all the way up this rock? I made it! Now I can scan the birds. Come back, birds! Let me look at you. Birdies! There we go. It's not scanning the birds. No! Alright, my scanner is recharging. I don't know what that means exactly. Let's check our multi-tool. Scanner. Yeah. Press target button to activate local scan. It's weird, but better than the PS4. Oh my gosh, I am sorry, chat. I have missed a whole bunch of stuff that you've been saying because it hasn't been scrolling. Read that as gender intermediate. Is that an octopus? Eat it! Its gender is radical. Sorry, Executor. You find Executor in a lot of reasons, both plant and dragon. So he have counts. It's not guns. Those dispense the custard. I am so sorry, folks. I hope you're still with us. I am sorry for ignoring you guys. Grimmyow says, it's weird, better than PS4, where things are just hanging there in the air. Oh, dear. Oh, dear. All right. Can I get any closer to these birds? Maybe I think this is where we die. Wait, there's some plutonium. Maybe I can get over there and heal my, heal my, suit. Oh, hello. Do I know you? Yes. Come on, come on. So how are you all doing tonight, chat? Oh gosh, that's not good.
Radiation damage detected.
Yeah, give me the plutonium. Eee, that's not good. Oh. Alright, hazard protection. I cannot charge hazard protection. Shoot. I can, however, charge my life support.
Technology recharge.
Can I just... Is there a way to see in mobile mode how many people are watching? I don't believe so. Three viewers. Hello, three viewers. I've just refreshed the chat to see if that fixes things. I should be able to interact with you a bit better now. I'm sorry for being so boring for the last little bit with the chat interaction and not quite seeing you all. Okay. So I've got all the heridium I need. I need more iron. Can I craft iron? Hello! I missed the octopus! I did! Was it back back the way I came? Because I think I'm going to have to going to have to go, let's see. I can't transfer this back because my starship is out of range. Shoot. Right. I wonder. Okay, I need more iron. Oh boy, now it's back a bit. Okay, well, I have entered sepia mode. Which means I am very close to dying. And I don't actually know where my ship is. Maybe it's this, but it's that way. Okay. I'm gonna level with you folks. I don't actually know. How to tell how close I am to dying. Ooh! I just ran smack dab into that. I'm thinking health is indicated by the little, Swiss crosses at the top of the screen? Perhaps? Oh gosh. Let's try and get as much. Oh gosh. I'm in bad shape, folks. We're in a bad way. Alright. I think I can do stuff with the iron here. I'm trying to remember what I was getting all this iron for. I had a reason. Zinc or titanium. I don't have titanium. Darn it. What can I make with... right, we're gonna transfer this back to our ship. I can craft a Karite sheet. But I don't really Alright, well, let's build it. Send that back, send that over. How many more do I need? Starship! Okay, we just needed those two, and now we need zinc. Where the heck do we get zinc from? Can I... scan. How do I... Alright. Oh, that's how we scan! Okay. There's aluminum. I don't want aluminum. I need zinc. Oh boy. Alright, well, Adrift died because of cat pictures. Yep. Rip me. I died because I was taking pictures of kitty cats. Okay, we got more iron, but we got lots of iron. I wanna get back to my starship now. Oh gosh. Well, I think that the upside to this... Oh, God. We're gonna die. We're dead. We're so dead. Also, am out of juice for the jump pack. Alright. Running. Oh, God. I don't think we can make it.
We died.
Here lies one from a distant star, but the soil is not it. Oh. Didn't give me a lot of time to read that. Oh well. Generation 1! Death by high speed ground impact. Okay. So we got ourselves rebuilt at our spaceship, which is good. I think all my stuff is... It does that. Yeah. Death by cat. Yeah, dying doesn't really matter, which is great. I think maybe it left my stuff out there? But I don't know. Is possible. Let us scan the area. So I hold down the button, I can... Ooh, what's that? It's isotopes. Alright, what else do we got? We got... That's our grave! If I say so. I forgot what I said already, I'm sorry. And we got this little science thing here. Let's check out the science thing. Did I already get these cats? I think I already got this cat. I will keep my eye out for the... Big kitty! Anyway, I will keep my eye out for the octopus this time around. Ooh. What's this? What is this? What is this? That's great. Yeah, I need isotopes for rad protection, but I yeah. It's a thing. So let's see. We just got platinum from a flower, which is pretty sweet, I gotta say. Yeah, no, for the hazard protection, I need zinc and titanium or a shielding shard. Isotopes refill my life support, but I was doing pretty good on life support. It was the radiation that was killing me. And eventually the fall. I was going to build a... Okay, so we need to get iron, and we need to get carbon. And my starship has some iron, I thought. Not anymore. Well, we can get some iron pretty quick. We only need 20 of the stuff, and we'll get some carbon, and, okay, yeah, those are carbon, the little isotopes in it. It bugs you that, that death doesn't matter? I could see that, like, not having too much consequence for it. I mean, it sort of matters in that all your stuff gets left behind, wherever you died. But, where's the octopus? I'm looking for the octopus. I don't see the octopus. Oh no.
Radiation protection.
Alright. Well, let's get some, is. I don't think it's an octopus. I think that's a... Oh, wait. Oh, cool. So that's a... Uh... Yeah, I definitely think it does make it more chill, which not dying for Mal, and I like that. And like dying can also be chill. Like I find Dark Souls pretty relaxing. Wow, I just realized what I said, and that was unfortunate wording. Yeah, it's a little too chill for me, removes too much tension. Yeah, I could definitely see that. I feel like there maybe is a happy middle somewhere, but it might just be difficult to implement with the way the game works otherwise. Like, I'm trying to think about how dying might have consequence in a game like this. Palmed bus. Give me the cash! It's a very nice hat. Well, it's sort of a survival game, but the dying wasn't that much. Yeah, it straddles the line between being sort of a survival game and being, like, an exploration game, and I could definitely see one kind of getting in the way of the other, possibly. Or perhaps mutually. Yeah, different modes would be awesome. You just, like, you play survival mode or you play, like, exploration mode. That would be fantastic. Especially because, like, there's not a lot of competition in this game. Like, yes, it's multiplayer and everybody's online technically in the same persistent world, but you're, like, zillions of light years apart and hardly ever going to encounter each other. So it's not like PvP is a thing exactly that we need to worry about. Oh, cool. Oh, hey, I can upload these. That's cool. All right. Records complete to receive. Okay, I don't quite understand. It's not actually the naming thing is shared. See, I've heard that, like, you can technically encounter other players, but it's just statistically unlikely. But oh, okay, so you can't actually see each other. That's interesting. They have been really vague, and I get the impression that they're not, like, being deliberately vague so much as not really knowing how to communicate their ideas in text or verbal form. But that could be just me giving them the benefit of the doubt. People found each other the first day. That's awesome. Okay, I'm going to go ahead and upload this. If I rename this, I could name it the Palmed Puss in honor of chat. Butessier. I think we're just going to upload it as is. Blenny Rorsark? Dia Vega Rorsark. Gender orthogonal. I still get a kick out of that. Gender exotic. All right. name that green thing Kitty? I don't actually know how the naming works. If it keeps the species name that gets assigned it, or if, and I'm just like adding a common name, or if I'm obliterating the species name. Well, let's be scientists. Name your discovery. Alright, here we go. Palm topus. Sweet. And we're just going to straight upload this one, I think. There we go. Units received. If there is one thing that history teaches us, it's that showing up unannounced in far-off lands and just naming things. Sorry, do you have a flag?
Units received.
We are basically doing the 19th century colonial thing. I am mildly,
Units received. Units received.
Claiming you discovered everything and renaming it never has negative consequences. Yeah, it's like that Eddie Izzard skit, right? Where he's just like, right, well, we've showed up and we have a flag, and that means we own this place now. And but we've lived here for centuries. You don't. How could you possibly own us? And it's like, well, do you have a flag? So yeah, let's be colonialists. Except we're at most doing the Darwin thing. We're not like going in and introducing smallpox and such. We're naming stuff. Oh, we can meet aliens. I definitely agree that we should name some things silly, but I'm also gonna try and name some things as I would, because this is, after all, it is my my what's it. But when there's something that's just too good to pass up. We'll have to. Yeah. So interesting. I do like literally terraforming. Are we? Are we changing the atmosphere of this place? Oh, I don't know how I feel about that. I wonder if I get a choice. Wait, I can probably scan that plutonium flower I found earlier. I forgot where that was. It was over here, I think. Aha! Killing all the plants, grabbing resources. Yeah, I kinda am. I kinda am. Acunusia vocarium. It's true. So I mean, we are exploiting, not in a like not at an industrial scale, but we are definitely doing that thing. Thank you. I don't know that I'm not introducing smallpox. You are correct, David. All of these animals and plants could die tomorrow because I didn't properly sanitize my environment suit. This is why NASA has planetary protection officers, BT-dubs, which happens to be the coolest title. We the Paddies. It's just, I've been looking at the insignia on our caps, and we've got skulls on them. Hans, are we the baddies? Alright, I'll just let my radiation suit recharge. That goes quite a long ways. Alright, so that scan found the thing. There's a big old question mark over there that I feel like should probably check out, but I'm gonna go revisit my grave, I think, in a little bit. Ooh, platinum. What do I have in my... Wait, maybe I can build stuff in here that I... Aha! Yes! Okay. Boltcaster. Okay, so this gives us a blaster weapon, basically, if we so choose. Or we can build a beam intensifier Sigma, which requires some titanium. Alright, I feel like that is something we do want to build, but the first order of business is not actually... tools, it is giving me something so I can run faster, and what do I need still for this guy? I need carbon. I thought I just grabbed some carbon. Did I not? What's that? There's a lot of military insignias. Have skulls on them. It is accurate. Targeted entity death. What's really amusing in a like guys really kind of way is all of the like the National Reconnaissance Organization, all of their like mission patch insignias for when they launch satellites and stuff is like, yeah, we're a creepy octopus spreading across the world, and it's like Do you guys... Is this meant to be self-awareness? or are you just kind of jerks? Alright, I don't think we actually got the carbon from these plants. Alright, I'm cold! That's why I'm breathing heavily. Hydra? Yeah. NROL39. Yep, that's the one. That's the spy satellite. Speaking of spy satellites, when I was in living in Maryland, I went to the National Air and Space Museum at Dulles, because they were having a special exhibit of a spy satellite that had recently been like declassified and stuff. It was called Hexagon, And it was the size of a semi-trailer. They launched it on an Atlas. They launched it on an Atlas for rocket in the 70s. It was a really cool piece of technology because they were doing what we do now with spy satellites digitally. They were doing it all analog. So is this giant, thing the size
Radiation
of
protection
a
on.
semi-trailer, rounded to fit inside, a rocket fairing. But it had all of these little pods on the bottom, which is where they would have the optical systems, and there was a system of mirrors inside. To direct the light to actual, like, reels of film. Yeah, it's near the Dulles Airport. It's not actually on, it's on the airport grounds, but you can't get to it from the airport. It's weird. But yeah, it that this hexagon spy satellite actually used big, giant reels of actual celluloid film, and they would point the telescope at a section of ground that they wanted to image, and they would reel the film through to sort of scan it slowly over the area that they wanted to get a picture of. And they would take these long sort of, it was all like synchronized mechanically and stuff, and they would take these long sweeping panoramas of huge stretches of land, and they could get very, very, very fine resolution on it because it was only limited by the grain of the film that they were using, not by pixels. So they could get really these really, really fine detailed images, but then to get them down to use them, they actually ejected the rolls of film. Like they you could they could they developed it and everything up there. In the little pod, it had like a little film developer thing going on in it, and then they would like scan. They had a something that was set up with vacuum tubes and stuff, a very sort of primitive digital TV, basically, transmitter up there to sort of scan this photograph, the way that a television scans its images through, and they could intercept that, but it was very low quality. To get the higher quality, the actual film itself, they would eject the pod with the film rolled up inside it, and it would come down through the atmosphere, and then it would have a little parachute on it, and they would go out to recover it before anyone else did. Which is, it's just crazy. Because this is the height of the Cold War, and all this stuff was, denied to even exist. And I don't know. I just, it's fascinating to me. I love technology like that, even though I hate the application. I'm really fascinated by the ingenuity that went into building it. And some of the just like very straightforward answers to technical questions like, well, how do you get the images down? We drop them. Right, what was I doing in here? All right, so we need, right, here's what we're going to do. We're going to move this thingy over here so I can keep all my technology together. And we're going to build this guy. Painless spinal puncture, epidural tap insertion, and bodily chemical distribution procedure. Lactic acid buildup in the user's body is neutralized during periods of heightened activity. Operates automatically once constructed within user's exosuit inventory. Cool. So we should now
radiation protection falling.
Be able to move a bit faster. Let's test that out. Yeah, they do have really slow lines at Dulles Airport. It's true. Wait, where's my spaceship? I don't know where my spaceship is. Over here. Dulles takes a long time to get through. Whereas Atlanta Airport is way bigger, but takes a lot less time to move through. Because you guys have, like, got the trains and stuff moving through. It's crazy. Yeah, Maverinthia, it would suck if someone got to them first, but on the other hand, I don't have a whole lot of Woo! We got a penis plant. But hey, it has zinc! Can I get more zinc from it? No, but maybe I can get some over here. Yeah, it would suck for them if someone got to the images first, and I think like they managed to go the whole program without that happening. But there were some close calls, and like definitely stuff like that definitely happened with spy planes and stuff. Like there was that U-2 pilot that got shot down over the Soviet Union because he was doing what spy pilots do. It's the Shin Megami Tensei guy! I am probably gonna have to name that something good. Oh dear. Let's see. So what am I working toward next here? Oh, I've actually got all the stuff I need for that. I need zinc for something else too, and I forgot what it was that I was looking for zinc for. Okay, zinc recharges my hazard suit. There was something else I could build. Okay, micro-density fabric, that's what gives us... I don't know what that does for us, but we can build it! Cool. Oh, it organizes into, Okay, cool. Enough gawking at menus, sorry folks. Oh wait, what could I do over here? Was there something I could do over here? I need titanium. I feel like I had some titanium. I don't really remember. Oh well, let us repair the pulse engine. Sweet. Now we just have to charge it, and we don't have... Oh, the music got cool. The music got real cool there. Alright, we can send our thomium over. Whoop! And we're gonna keep some zinc on hand. Some platinum on hand, maybe some carbon on hand. Maybe. No, actually, I think I am going to. Charge my life support here with a tiny little bit of. Plutonium. Or maybe I'll charge it with some carbon. That did not do much. I don't actually remember how much I have of that stuff. Got 133 plutonium. Okay. Okay. Cool. Cool, cool, cool. Alright.
Zoop. Technology recharge. Objective complete.
Mara-chan, yeah, the penis chariot. One day I might return to Shin Megami Tensei Persona 2, but it won't be soon. Journey milestone accomplished. What did we do? Starship repair. Oh, okay, cool. That was a nice little bit of incidental music. Can I look at anything here? I feel like I should be able to scan all of this stuff. But I cannot. Oh, hello. I can scan the shiny, though. Boosty Mezulumia. Let's pick it. Actually, no. We're gonna leave it. We're gonna leave it. We're gonna leave it alone. I don't need to pick every flower and destroy every piece of things that I find. Let's go revisit our gravesite, though, after we gather some more plutonium. Because I have a feeling this planet is really rich in plutonium, and other places may not be, so we might want to stock up a little bit. I agree with you, Cassandra, your point from earlier about having separate modes of survival and exploration, because this is starting to feel a little bit like Grocery Simulator. which is fine. I don't mind that. Does aluminum give us anything? I don't actually remember if it's common or uncommon or what. I also think we have some on our grave, so we're going to run. I do move slightly faster now, which is good. Ooh. Hello, pretties. Oh. It's a new flower. And that also gives me carbon. So, my headcanon is that we're getting carbon from these plants by, like, picking them, crushing them, and incinerating them. That is... Wait, is this a plant too? Oh, it's a mineral. Just like to feel like there's more at stake, I guess. Yeah. Like, I kind of get that there's these little watcher robots flying around. And we do have, like, this environmental stuff going on, but I'd like to grab my stuff from my grave and okay, we already got this guy. I'd like to get the stuff for my grave and actually get to the flying around and exploring a bit. And discover new places. Alright. I also... I understand that there's not very many first-person games that let you do this. Skyrim does, but not very many others. I would like more first-person games to give you the option, especially if they're not, like, multiplayer, like, competitive shooters or whatever. I would like more first-person games to give you the option of going to a third-person perspective on your character. Because I'm way more comfortable navigating third-person than I am first-person. Fuel launch thrusters. Yes, I understand. I need to fuel the launch thrusters. There's a tiny little thing up here. I wonder... Oh, it's a leaf! Hello, lonely little leaf. What are you doing up here? Hi! I can get iron from you, apparently. I cannot scan you, though. I'm gonna leave you where you are. I don't want to destroy you. You're very happy up here. I do want to see what I can do about that thing. Yeah, that's where we died. Okay. We were trying to... Oh, hello? Yes? Be gone with you! Alright. Hey, Drift, we are dying horribly. A little help? Oh, a leaf! A tiny little leaf! Hello, leaf! I mean... It's not inaccurate. But also, there's really no sense of urgency here for me to, be rushing through, so I do like taking my time and exploring, looking at pretty things, but I am ready to find some new environments. What else is there to see on this planet, though? Because I feel like there's lots of stuff I'm not, I haven't found yet. Yeah, there's like... There's a bunch of things to do here, apparently, or see, and I haven't, and Hussite. I guess we could rename that if we wanted to. There's the Chetus. It's Chet. It sounds like a frat boy. Chetus retaligorium. It's a plant that is a frat member who's really into Latin. But yeah. We are going to rename this. We are going to rename this. Marachan Engorgium. Nope, it's not how you spell. God damn it.
Units received.
I am 12. Let's see. Canusia Vocarium. I actually like that name. We'll just upload that as is.
Units received. Units received.
Ui Hybium Hateloto. And Enhusite.
Units received. Funk.
All right.
Radiation protection falling.
All right, I'm moving pretty quick now. That's good. I like that. Oh, hello, music. Yes. Esteniite. Wonder if I can land on it. I can! And it won't eat me. Because apparently this is a mineral? Sure. Sure. This is totally a rock. It just formed this way. Absolutely. I hear critters. Where are critters? Zinc. We can use that.
Technology recharge.
Oh, that did just like a tiny little bit. Realize it's 11, so it is a Friday night, so I hope everyone is enjoying themselves and this isn't too boring for you. We're gonna see if we can get off this planet tonight. That is our goal. We get off this planet and go from there. I want to get off this planet. I want to fly around in space a little bit and maybe see if we can find another planet. Because that sounds like fun. And I think that would be a natural sort of stopping place as well for the stream. Sort of we've hit the major features of the game, and we have something to return to later. Okay, so that's what those little things are in the logo.
Radiation protection falling.
Cool. All right, so we got our thomium, we got our bypass chip.
more carbon, which is good for our life support system. I don't know what aluminum lets us do. We've got carbon, lets us recharge our thingy, and we're out of zinc. And we're rapidly running out of radiation shielding. So, bearings here. All right. Running. I betcha this thing has stuff. Yep, that's a thing with stuff. I wonder what it is. I mean, we might not live long enough to find out, but let's at least take a look. Ooh, iridium. That seems good, possibly. Oh, I see. It's got, like, veins of iridium inside the aluminum stuff. So that's cool. That's pretty rad. So you actually do have to kind of, like, mine the stuff. Interesting. Very interesting. Right. Okay. All right, and now my thrusters are completely not charged anymore.
Radiation protection falling.
Sorry, just taking care of some messages. Alright. We can make it back to our ship before we die. Because it's right down here. And I'm also going to see if I can scan whatever these things are. The birds also seem to have moved on. This is a pretty cool looking plant. Ooh! Wait a second. What does this plant give us? Ooh! Interesting. That's what gives us more of our thomium here. Which we are going to transfer to our starship. Do I have more? I don't have any more zinc. Darn. All right. We don't really need more carbon. Carbon is going to be plentiful everywhere, I have a feeling. What is this rock? What do we want to name some of these things? Palmtopus. Is that what this is? The Palmtopus thingies. Right. Well, let's just decide that these are in the same genus when we get back to our ship, because we are about to die. Let's run. Running, Batman. Goodness gracious. Oop. No, I do not want to die this way. Okay. Come on. You can do this. Run! The octopus plant seems to have that red bulb plant near it. Yeah. They do seem to be associated with each other. I wonder if that's just coincidence or if there's actually like a rule somewhere buried deep in the algorithm that generates this place that suggests that they hang out together. I bet there is something like that. And while our radiation shielding is slowly dying, I will pick up some more plutonium. What do these give us? Ooh, it's a new thing! Alvagium aurifragifium. It looks like a coral, almost. Alright, ooh! Hello, are you a new animal? No, you're an animal I already know. I already know you. I know you! Alright. On our way to the spaceship. We'll be there shortly. Are these new? They are new! Sweet! Look at these guys! Oh my gosh, they're cute! That's awesome! They're like little tauntauns! I like that, I dig that. Okay. Alright. Oh, I got damaged. That's not good. Alright. Alright, that's affecting our shield, I guess. So let's hop in here. Whew. And see if that, like, heals us at all. Meanwhile, we need to charge this with thomium. Sweet! Excellent. And this needs to be charged with plutonium. Time for David to head to bed. Good night, all. Take care! David, it was fun having you around for the stream. Sorry you didn't get to see space. Because I'm pretty sure we are, like, right about to head to space. So let's...
Technology recharge. Technology recharge.
Okay, cool. So now... we're not actually going to turn our guns on. Because hopefully we won't need them. We are going to turn our guns on, actually, as I think about it. Oh, maybe we can't.
Objective complete.
Alright, so we hold R1 to take off. That is not working. What are our controls here? Quick, to space! Our right trigger? No. Left brake, roll left, exit ship, initiate landing, fire weapons. Galactic map, scan. No, what's... Tell me how to take off. What? Alright, maybe it will tell us when we jump back in. Alright, just jump back in. It should. Right bumper, left bumper, right trigger, left trigger, right bumper and left trigger. Nope. We'll go ahead and, come on. Alright, we're just going to go ahead and gather these really quick.
Units received.
Zip.
Units received. Units received. Units received.
They're going to... Ubeneral. Tauntaun. If my keyboard would cooperate.
Units received.
Okay. Okay, is there more that I've missed? I don't think so. Okay. How do I lift off? Uh-oh. Alright. Engine hold right, left bumper and right bumper together. Hold right trigger to take off from a planet. Alright. Hold right trigger to take off. Okay, here we go. Oh. Here we are. Oh god. I am... Oh... Okay. This is a thing. This is some ham. I have to get used to the controls. What is this thing? Is this a good thing? I actually can't tell what that is. That seems to be... Oh, it's resources. There's a point of interest which we can approach. How do I move faster? R to accelerate. Okay, we can't actually seem to do that. But I want to see what's at this green point. And then we go to space. What is this guy? Okay, we're going to space in just a second. I'm trying to see if I can land this ship. There's a building, though. I gotta see what's in the building. And then we go to space. Because the building might have something nice for us. Good for us. Oh, okay, we already discovered that. Whoa, there's a bunch of resources over there. Alright. Can we go inside here? What is this? Sweet. It's a house! It's a house! It's an alien! No, I'm not going to spend 8 hours looking at plants. I'm just... But there's an alien! Lieutenant BG. He's got pedipalps! David, he has pedipalps! Okay, I don't actually know his language. I hurriedly mime that I am peaceful. Nigga shows which elements I can carry. I do my best to keep calm. I will give you some oxide. Sweet! I learned some language. Sweet.
You've learned the Vakin word for interloper.
Okay, cool. So that has introduced us to another mechanic, which we will want to explore in detail later. But for now, space! Right trigger. Takes off. Excellent. There was a green thing, but it is gone now. So that is cool. Now we go to space! 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 We're launching.
We're off to outer space. We're leaving Tomobiki High.
Alright. Come on. Space! Fly up using LS, left stick, to hold B to engage boost. Engaging boost. Oh my god! We're in space! We're in space! Holy fuck! I am so happy right now! This is worth it. This is completely worth it! Oh, holy hell! I am so happy right now! Look, there's ships! So our next goals are to acquire hyperdrive technology, build a hyperdrive, and then find fuel. Yeehaw! What is that? What is that? Arrive in 4 hours! No. Ooh. But there is a planet over there that we can get to if we boost. Oh god, we're gonna hit something. Hold on to your hats, folks. Nope, no autopilot. We're doing this manually. Oh god. Okay, that's a space station. What is? No, there's something more here. Whoa. Can't stabilize it. Oh, I just shot at a planet. That's not good. I'm gonna go ahead and say that's not good. No, I don't want to go down. No. No. We go up. Okay. Wow. This controls like a son of a something. Okay. We have very little control over our orientation when we are boosting. Oh god! I feel a little like Han Solo here right now. I'm not gonna lie. Also, no. Can I point up, please? Point up, please. Holy shit. I mean, let's be honest. I would be about this bad at flying a spaceship in real life. Okay. We're going to fly to Leonard's Ray Duizy. Engaging pulse engine. I don't know what we're doing, folks! Incoming signal. That is maybe not good. 50 seconds? 40 seconds? The colors! Approaching ludicrous speed! God. This is so exciting! I also have no control. We are just locked in here to this trajectory. We are 30 seconds away from whatever these things are. Oh my god. Holy shit. All right. We're getting there. We're almost... 10 seconds, 15, 14. All right, we're gonna find the beacon. How do I come back? Shoot. How do I exit? right. Boost is B, roll left, exit ship, initiate landing, pulse engine. This isn't actually very helpful. Press them again? Maybe. Ooh! God. Nope. Holy... Oh my god. We're gonna We are in the space station. And now I'm in a space station. Can I run to the edge of the space station? Okay, it's actually a lot farther than it looks. Wow! Yeah, I really thought we were gonna, like, run into the space station. Okay, so... Yes, have a good night, sir. I am going to bed also. We seem to be being joined by someone. Oh, God. I sure hope they're friendly. Good night, sir. This seems to be a spaceship. Oh, sweet. It's a person interloper something 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 mark of acceptance shows a willingness to trade. Make an offer on the lifeform starship. Okay, we're gonna cancel this for right now. I might want his ship. I might want that ship. Holy hell. Okay. This is a rad looking ship. Alright, so this must be where we get to sort of pick our, what we're gonna go for. I'm kind of a fan of... Oh! Did it leave? It left! No, I'm not gonna kill him! What is this ship? Okay. Covers its teeth and stares out toward me. Let's make an offer. Well, this turns into Space Quest. Alright, what can I... Alright, it's got... I don't have nearly enough units for this ship. I really want this ship, but I don't have nearly enough units for it. So we're gonna have to leave for now. Oh no, the other ship I liked is leaving! No, wait, come back! Holy crap. Alright, so this seems to be procedural as well. I'm hoping that more cool ships come in the future, but at the moment I'm going to quit. I'm going to quit while I'm ahead. Holy crap! These ships all look so cool! Okay. Let's save and quit. So we just saved a second ago. We're going to quit to desktop. And that is that, folks, is No Man's Sky. Holy cow. That was a lot of fun. I will be streaming more of this in the future, but for now, take care. And have a great night, and thanks for wandering with me. Have a good evening. Ciao.